On this page, I want to discuss a specific reaction that hydrazones can undergo, and that's called Wolff-Kischner reduction. So the Wolff-Kischner reduction is a reaction that completely removes carbonyls. Now, I'm not sure if you guys are already familiar with these reactions or if you've studied them yet, but there's two reactions that you learn in organic chemistry too that also completely remove carbonyls. One is called Clemmensen reduction. Does that sound familiar? And the other one is called thioacetals plus Rainey nickel. Okay? Well, it turns out, guys, that this is just going to be another method. So there's a third method that we can use to completely get rid of a carbonyl and turn it into an alkane. Okay? Now, the way we do this is by using an ammonia derivative to make an amine derivative. Let's see how. What we do is we take a carbonyl, you react it with hydrazine. Hydrazine is going to add and make an amine derivative. Specifically, the amine derivative that we make is called hydrazone. If you recall, hydrazone is the combination of hydrazine with a ketone, so it's hydrazone. Once you have your hydrazone, usually you would be done. Usually this would be the end of the reaction. Okay, it's reversible. But if you react this hydrazone in a base catalyzed environment, you're going to get a completely different product. What you're actually going to get is the generation of an N2 gas, which I'll show you. You're going to get N2 gas to evolve, and you're going to get an alkane. So the reagents we usually use for this are some strong base. NaOH works just great. In your textbook, you might see KOH or terbutoxide. It doesn't matter. It's just some strong base. Usually there's an alcohol present to help the reaction along. Now this alcohol is not in the mechanism. It's just there to provide correct conditions for the mechanism to take place. Ethylene glycol, as shown here, is a really common one. And you need heat. You need some kind of heat to get the reaction going, okay? So now what I'm gonna do is in the next video, I'm gonna show you guys the whole mechanism for Wolff-Kischner reduction.